As friends, family, co-workers, and the parish community of St. Jerome, we have come together in the presence of God to witness the celebration and blessing of the loving union which exists between Brad Brown and Eric Sanchez. In this service, we are reminded of Christ's two greatest commandments, that we love God above all else, and that we love our neighbors as we love. We respond to God's love in many ways, always remembering the meaning of true love includes commitment, respect, mutual giving and receiving, self-sacrifice, and the determination to avoid all force, triviality, and exploitation, all of which was shown to us through the life of Jesus Christ. From the earliest times, men and women have made solemn vows before witnesses and in the sight of God. The stories of David and Jonathan and of Ruth and Naomi remind us of two such vows made before God, in which they called on God to witness and to bless the love they swore to each other. Like these biblical examples, Rack and Eric have come today to affirm and deepen their love and commitment to each other and to ask God's blessing as they offer their life together to their Creator. We welcome all of you to this service that celebrates and affirms the relationship between Rack and Eric. You are a vital part of this service, not just an audience. Your interest, your love, and prayers mean much to both of you. It is written that the greatest of all things and the most wonderful experience in the world is love.
Rack and Eric, a deep and lasting love has entered your lives, and you have asked this church and its ministry to help you celebrate and affirm this love.
We rejoice to be part of this celebration. We have loved and valued you separately. We will continue to love and value you in your relationship. So say we all.
Rack and Eric, you are about to make a solemn promise. Do you believe God has called you to live together in love?
We do.
Do you promise to be loyal to each other, never allowing any other relationship to come before the one you are now to affirm?
We do.
Will you give yourselves wholeheartedly and without reserve?
We will.
Will you do all in your power to make your life together a witness to the love of God in the world?
We will.
Under God, will you recognize each other's freedom to grow as individuals and to allow each other time and space to do so?
We will.
Rack, will you give yourself wholly to Eric, sharing your love and life, your steadfastness and vulnerability, your joys and sorrows, your health and sickness, your riches and poverty, your successes and failures?
I will.
Eric, will you give yourself wholly to Rack, sharing your love and life, your steadfastness and vulnerability, your joys and sorrows, your health and sickness, your riches and poverty, your successes and failures? All of you present here today are witnesses to these promises. Will you do all in your power to support Rack and Eric in their marriage?
We will.
Again, if two lie together, they keep warm.
But how can one keep warm alone? And then one may prevail against another, two will withstand one. A three-fold cord is not quickly broken. The word of our God.
Thanks be to God.
Today's Psalm 145 is found in the program to select. You are invited to chant with the choir. The chant tones are also in the program.
Face to face. Now I only know in part,
now know me fully, even as I have been fully known, and now have faith, hope, and love of God, these three, and the greatest of these, is love. The word of our God.
Thanks be to God.
You will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Rack was into rock bands and had just a little touch of partier. Still does. And Eric has never changed. In all the years that I have known him, what you see is what you get. You can set your watch by Eric. Eric also has opinions. What we started in, session after session after session. Did I tell you that at that time they had this thing called a Nile monster? It's one of those lizards. One of those big iguana lizards, like this big. It has teeth about that long, and they had it in this great big aquarium. And I'd keep my good eye on it when I was there, and it would glare at me every session. We went through everything that I go through with values clarification for couples. And finally, we were through. We were all exhausted. And I thought, well, Lord, it's in your hands. I've done all that I can do as a mortal. Let's hope they make it. So then I waited for them to call me and say, Father, we need to set a wedding date. Never mind some sermons that I preached on matrimony, getting things in my head. Finally, I had to retire. And I'm glad that I'm upright to participate in this momentous occasion. And I'm also humbled and honored, as I know Father Duane is also. Because you see, it is one of life's greatest mysteries of how two people come together, how they meet one another, how some magical and mystical spark is kindled within each, and especially how they happen to take a risk of giving voice to their private feelings with one another. And from ages forgotten and long before recorded time, humanity has rejoiced and offered prayers and hope and thanksgiving when two people have found each other. Today, Eric and Rack, we gather to stand as witnesses to contribute to your public declaration of your love. And today, all of us join together to give our blessing to the joining of this couple who have actually found each other. But you know, what makes this celebration today distinctly different is also part of life's mystery. There's love, there's commitment, there's the church, there's beautiful music, beautiful flowers, there's family, friends, priests, lots of caring people. But the people who are pledging their devotion, loyalty, and love and responsibility are of the same gender. Now, this may be a first for some of you here today, and this reality will increase the need for honest conversation. This reality will increase the need for showing respect to one another, and this reality will increase the amount of responsibility you must take forward and with one another. Because in reality, it's not easy for any two people to love one another. And it's really not easy for a same-gender couple to love one another. Because it's not always easy to proclaim your affection, your attachment, or your bond openly. For many are not willing yet to see beyond their own fears and celebrate the love which we are witnessing this afternoon. Yet Eric and Rack, through all the years, have chosen to do it. And you've done it with candor and frankness. You are forcing new paths of growth for many people, and we're touched deeply that you are joining your lives together. And you have probably already done this with many of the people in the nave today. Remember that we are gathered here with you because we believe that you have the right to publicly and legally declare and express your love. We are gathered with you because we honor and recognize the bond between you, and we stand with and beside you to assist you in any way that we can. You might remember this statement from your counseling session, Jim, I know. That the sacrament of Christian marriage is more than just a ceremony. It is an enduring relationship represented by Christ's love to the church. And our gospel reading and our great teacher Christ points the way for his disciples by giving us the commandment to love as he has loved us. We're given a primer for the Christian walk. There were and are bigotries and persecutions for believing in Christ. And Jesus was warning his followers to stand fast to his commandments and give love to one another, even until death, because it is the bond that God, Jesus, and the church, and their love for one another, would see them through the persecutions and the bigotries of the time. Eric and Rack, I have known you through some joyful times, and I've known you through some difficult times. And I know you love each other deeply, and that your commitment is strong enough to meet any of life's challenges. I know that you love to laugh, and you have a great capacity for fun. By this little aliens up here in the pulpit. Don't ask me. I tried to steer them away from all that New Mexico stuff, too. That's like the wedding cake when you see it. I put some holy water on their way out. And I know that you are both individual people with independent spirits that make a strong partnership. And I know that you've been together long enough and have been through enough to know about loving and making space for one another to be the person that each needs to be. And for anybody, it's real hard to love this way, to not grasp, to not clutch, to not control the other, but rather to be with one another lightly, fluidly, and flexibly. And I applaud your commitment as I've watched you through the years to love in this way. That is probably one of the reasons why you have journeyed this far in your relationship. And as you enter into the new stage of your relationship that this celebration marks, I would counsel you to continue to love one another deeply, but always with a sense of freedom. Those are my admonishments. But I also have some hopes and prayers for you. I wish for you continuing harmony, creativity, play, and laughter. When there is conflict, as you know, already know that there will be, may your wisdom and faithfulness enable you to grow through it and be strengthened by it, and that the bonds of love are rooted in that source of life itself. I wish for you always a kind of community to surround you. No couple you see comes together alone, but with a whole cast of significant people whose lives have touched their own. May you be blessed with ongoing love and support as you move into the future together. And may the joy you share in your relationship continue to spill over into lives of all the people that you know. And may you carry the past gracefully with you in all the years of your stay. The enriching old ties and feelings, and the equal measure of hope to face the future. These are my hopes and prayers for you as you find them. Come before this community, to this altar, to receive the sacrament of marriage. And for all of us gathered here today, let us be as the ancient church,
and believe that Christ's final commandment is that we love one another, and that our joy may be full, and that there is no greater love than the love that Christ exhibited by giving his life so that we can live. Very good, Rand. I wish you love, joy, and wisdom. Secure in the knowledge, that you will be my constant friend and my one true love. On this holy day, I affirm to you, in the presence of God and everyone in attendance, my sacred promise to stay by your side in sickness and in health, in joy and in sorrow, as well as through the good times, and the bad times. I further promise to love you without reservation. Comfort you in times of distress. Encourage you to achieve higher goals. Laugh with you and cry with you. Grow with you in mind and spirit. Always be open and honest with you. And cherish you as long as we both shall live. This is my solemn vow. I, Eric, take you, Rad, to be my faithful partner, bearing the knowledge that you will be my constant friend and my one true love. On this holy day, I affirm to you, in the presence of God and everyone in attendance, my sacred promise to stay by your side in sickness and in health, in joy and in sorrow, as well as through good times. I further promise to love you without reservation, comfort you in times of distress, encourage you to achieve higher goals, laugh with you and cry with you, grow with you in mind and spirit, always be open and honest with you, and cherish you as long as we both shall live. This is my solemn vow.
Bless, O God, these rings to be a sign of the vows which these two individuals bind themselves to each other through Jesus Christ our Lord. The circle is a symbol of the sun and of the earth. It is a symbol of wholeness and perfection. A ring is a symbol of unity into which your two lives are now joined in an unbroken circle. Through this circle of love, wherever you go, you will return to one another. this ring as a symbol of my vow. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I pronounce that they are one before God and are united in heart and soul before their family and friends in the name of the Creator, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder.
So say we all.
A comforter in sorrow, and a companion in joy.
Amen.
Grant that their wills will be knit together in your will, and their spirits in your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with you and one another all the days of their life.
Amen.
Give them grace when they hurt each other, to recognize and acknowledge their fault, to seek each other's forgiveness and yours.
Amen.
Make their life together a sign of Christ's love to all people in this world, that unity may overcome estrangement, forgiveness may heal guilt, and joy may conquer despair.
Amen.
Give them such fulfillment of their mutual affection that they may reach out in love and concern for others.
Amen.
Grant that all persons who have witnessed these vows may find their lives strengthened and their loyalties confirmed.
Amen.
Grant that the bonds of our common humanity, by which your children are united one to another, may be so transformed by your grace that they reflect your will on earth as it is in heaven, where Father, with Christ, and with the Holy Spirit you live and reign in perfect unity, now and forever.
Amen.
Holy God, mighty God, immortal God, adored by angels and praised by the saints, receive the prayers of your holy church and grant them in accordance with your gracious will through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Most gracious God, we give you thanks for your tender love in sending Jesus Christ to come among us, to be born of a human mother, and to make the way of the cross to be the way of life. We thank you also for consecrating the marriage of these two men in this name. By the power of the Holy Spirit, pour out the abundance of your blessings upon Rack and Eric. Defend them from every enemy. Lead them into all peace. Let their love for one another be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle upon their shoulders, and a crown upon their foreheads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking.
in their joys and in their sorrows, in their life and in their death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that table when your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. Through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God forever and ever.
Amen.
God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. May the Lord look upon you with mercy and favor, and fill you with all spiritual benediction and grace, that you may faithfully live together in this life and in the age to come, and have everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice and our commands to the praise and glory of God's name for our good.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is truly right to glorify you, Father, and to give you thanks. For you alone are God, living in truth, dwelling in light, inaccessible from before time and forever. Fountain of life and source of all goodness, you made all things and filled them with your blessing. You created them to rejoice in the splendor of your radiance. Countless throngs of angels stand before you to serve you night and day. And beholding the glory of your presence, they offer you unceasing praise. Joining with them and giving voice to every creature under heaven, we acclaim you and glorify your name as we sing. Descent among the dead, proclaiming his resurrection and ascension to your right hand, awaiting his coming in glory, and offering to you from the gifts you have given this bread and this cup. We praise you and we bless you.
We praise you. We bless you.
We give thanks
to you.
And we praise you, Lord our God. Lord, we pray that in your goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be holy gifts for your holy people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that all who share this bread and this cup may become one body and one spirit, a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your name. Remember, Lord, your one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, redeemed by the blood of your Christ. Reveal its unity, guard its faith, and preserve it in peace. Remember Rack and Eric's parents and all those who helped shape their lives and understanding of commitment. Remember Rack and Eric as they persevere in the relationship they have begun, so that when your Son comes in glory, he may welcome them into the marriage feast of the Son. And grant that we may find our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all the saints who have found favor with you in ages past. We praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty God and Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Thank you.
the Almighty Father give you joy in sharing with one another.
Amen.
May the only Son of God have mercy on you and help you in good times and in bad.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit of God fill your hearts with divine and everlasting love.
Amen.
And may the blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.